Well, this video update is about a very important meeting that happened today. I don't want to get too much into detail with it, but let me sort of more or less say that the meeting was about the way of including autism more in a work setting, and also about looking at something like an enterprise bargaining agreement to be able to work at ways of making autism far better utilised within the enterprise bargaining. So this might be more flexible arrangements or just more inclusion of autism, seeing autism as an advantage, seeing the attributes of having autism as an advantage in a work scenario or in a productive sense. So the meeting today went really well, and I also was accompanied by a representative from the union, and I've also spoken to unions about, well, advised unions on ways to be more accommodating for persons on the autism spectrum. And you may have watched a video by Gary Namy about how a union is an employee's advocate, and this is, well, an employer's representative in a work setting, and this is very true, and it's something that does need a lot of attention. So I am 42 in the middle of August, the 17th of August, and I reached this stage of life, being in my early 40s, which is an achievement because, sadly, that not everybody gets to this stage in life, and not everybody has the opportunities that I have. And I'm grateful for the team of support that I'm having, and from supporters within the community that have helped me to get this far in life. Tomorrow I will be speaking to the National Disability Insurance Scheme. Well, actually, I won't be speaking too much in detail with that, but I'm going to be speaking to a lady by the name of Claire. Claire is the Executive Director of Disability Services, and I will be also talking to Jason, who is the Associate Director of the NDIS Planning and Implantation. So that's what his current role is, and I'll be having a chat to them tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock, and I'll be putting the cards on the table, so to speak, about being an adult on the autism spectrum and ways that the NDIS can hopefully get kick-started here in Queensland, particularly Brisbane and the southeast Queensland region is where I'm currently living. So this will be something that will hopefully be productive. I'll be taking that call tomorrow morning, and I'll be talking with the representatives from Disability Services and also from the National Disability Insurance Scheme. I really hold great hope that with the National Disability Insurance Scheme, that it will represent people with disabilities, with challenges, not so much just recruit people that all they're interested in at the end of the week is how much of a pay packet they have. I hope to see that there will be people that will be concerned about those of us in the disability sector, and to shift the stigma from a negative one to a positive one of being an attribute, of being something that is positive and something that has potential. So please wait and see on what progress can be made with this. I'm also talking to a female on the who has autism. She's in Sydney, and we are very much getting on quite nicely, which is good, but that's very just sort of things that are happening in the background. I've sort of decided that with internet dating websites that they're really just a waste of time. They just don't get anywhere with them, so I don't really bother with them very much anymore. I don't put a lot of emphasis into them. The Asperger adult group meets this Saturday, and we should have a good meeting. We're welcoming new members, and we also have Professor Dr. Tony Atwood visiting the group on Saturday the 23rd of August. So please stay tuned for more updates. If you have any queries or comments that you wish to make, please feel free to post them to accompany this video. Thanks very much for watching.